Hello, my name is Veerle Haverhals and I work for the University of Antwerp, Belgium. This ILSA project video will give an overview on how to listen to audio in language A and reformulate in language B while using speech recognition. We continue to build on what you have learned in the previous modules, that is, the modules on subtitling, on simultaneous interpreting, and on intralingual respeaking. Simultaneous interpreters convert spoken messages from language A to language B. They take into account fixed expressions and proverbs, jargon, etc., but also the cultural specificities of their target audience. This is no different for interlingual respeakers. However, they have to do more than convert the spoken message from language A to language B, taking all of this into account. They also have to address their spoken language to the speech recognition software, which is a separate skill. As a result, some techniques are the same for simultaneous interpreters and interlingual respeakers, whereas others are not. What is very similar is the décalage, or the time that is left between the spoken message in the source language and the moment the interpreter starts speaking. This décalage depends on the difference between the source language and the target language, as well as the interpreter or respeaker's experience. For example, if you interpret between two Roman languages, the décalage will be smaller due to the linguistic similarity of the languages than if you interpret from a Roman language to a Germanic language, and vice versa. Novice interpreters tend to start talking too quickly and get caught up in their own words. What about the differences? Simultaneous interpreters are advised not to interrupt their speech flow with silences, which is why they often use stopgap sentences. Such sentences can be quite devoid of content or, for instance, repetitions. Interlingual respeakers avoid this at all times. The speech recognition software needs time to process the respeaker audio. The respeaker must also dictate punctuation marks and, moreover, additional sentences can cause speech recognition errors that, in their turn, need to be corrected. Therefore, the interlingual respeakers will often have to limit themselves to the essence of the message they are respeaking. Repetitions, even if they occur in the original message, are omitted, and the interlingual respeaker will summarize all the relevant information without omitting any relevant content. In this part, we will start with fairly easy videos and gradually move on to more advanced and difficult material. The purpose of these exercises is first and foremost to train some live interpreting skills and to combine them with the respeaking skills that are meant to produce written text. Keep the following in mind. You must maintain enough temporal distance from what you hear when you respeak, the décalage, but stay close enough in order to remember all that has been said. And leave short breaks in between the sentences while you respeak, so that the speech recognition software has sufficient time to transcribe your text. Choose now one of the texts from the library in practice videos and take a beginner level. Respeak the video into your chosen language. Good luck!